Manjo is a community health officer working in the Callaghan district in Sierra Leone. A grandfather of one, he is no stranger to tragedy, having lost his six siblings to HIV and the Civil War. Now he's living at the centre of one of the areas worst affected by the Ebola epidemic. Usually Manjo's job involves performing minor operations, but since the outbreak he has joined the disease surveillance team, also known as the disease detectives. Every day Manjo's team ventures out into the surrounding villages, looking for new cases. They check people for symptoms of Ebola, and if they see signs they bring them to the Médecins Sans Frontières treatment centre. Once a case has been confirmed, Manjo's team then has to track down every person the patient has come into contact with. Manjo and his colleagues used to wear protective gear whilst they worked, but found that the suits frightened villagers who ran away, potentially spreading the disease even further. So now their only line of defence is to stay 2 meters away from every person they meet.
Actually, easy to have people who are very willing to work. So the few only ones have, you know, more work to do.
Manjo himself has been quarantined after being pricked by a needle when taking blood from someone who turned out to have Ebola. Thankfully, on this occasion, it was a false alarm, but many local doctors and nurses have already died. No one knows how many people in Sierra Leone are currently infected. The latest official figures suggest there have been somewhere between 1,000 and 1,500 deaths, but the true number is much, much higher. Manjo is currently training to take swabs from dead people in their homes to test for Ebola, a task that is even more dangerous than his current work. But despite the constant risk, he refuses to give up the fight.
If I give up, it's like I'm putting more people at risk. They will transmit the disease to a lot of people, and many people will die, we will not be able to control the situation.